Didn't expect to make a fishing video here today. It's a new lake. Haven't been here before. This is in Hodgenville, Kentucky. That's because it's so hot, there's no shade. The lake is very pretty, but you have to do some walking. Let me show you. Move the camera here. You can fish in this small area here, which is quite fun. I caught a lot. Or all along that embankment there, all the way to the other side and around. But that's a lot of walking. You got a little road that goes up the hill here, but it stops right up there somewhere. So I think it's just a walking path. I flew the drone earlier to get a look, to get an overview. The lake goes way back there. I can see some roads off in the woods to get other places, but you never know whether it goes through somebody's private property, which is something you have to watch here. That gets you in some trouble. So, don't know if I can get the camera back in the original spot, but that'll work. So, I just did this. I tried here, see what happened. I've seen some really big fish coming in and out of this place, out of this little spot here. So I tried it out. Caught some nice perch. There was a guy fishing next to me. He just left. Bless his heart, he didn't know that where he was fishing was only like 6 inches deep. Let fish come in all out of here. And he was fishing for catfish. Just not going by quite the right way. Here's a turtle I caught who still hasn't moved yet. See if I can get my shadow off of him and zero in right there. So we're gonna see if we can get him to move back in the water. I think he's trying to hide. Go back in the water, dude. So, caught that too. There he goes. Now he's attempting to flee. And he's slowly about to ease back in the water. So you catch a little bit of everything here. There he goes, headed back in. And away we go. Back in the water. So let's find that magic spot again where we were fishing. Okay, back there again. So, very hot. Anyway, flying the drone up there, and I was checking out, I was flying the drone and checking out Google Maps, trying to see if there were other trails around here to get other places by the lake, but there were none, so I'll just stay right here. This will be it. So my bait of choice today is some little red wigglers. This will really get everybody. You can see that in my hand. I really should try a little rooster tail or a blue fox. Earlier I wasn't filming.
did catch some small baby bass. There's a lot of big perch,
bluegill, as they say in Kentucky. Let me see what the video looks like. The video looks okay. And there be another one. Fish for a few more minutes and call it a day. it shows up on the camera. This is what I got, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 perch. That's what I got so far. That's dinner. Fishing with worms is a very dirty job. All right, we're in the final few minutes before we pack it up for the day, so I just got one more. We have 10. We got 10 perch. We have 10. That's what we got so far, as everybody can see. I know in Kentucky, they like to say bluegill, but I'm from Louisiana, and we say perch, can perch. So there you have it. Another one, but small. So this may be the last one right here before I take off. Number 11. Okay, I lied. One more time. I would say what I'm surprised at on the worms, it's only a perch come up. Caught one baby bass, but I'm kind of really surprised that no catfish come up or crappie. It's usually a good bait to use to see what would like, I still like to spin, but I don't know. Getting to be a time crunch. Let's stay 15 more minutes. And then I have to leave. Throw these on some ice. And you will be fine. know some of you have probably seen these orange floats I'm using. They're kind of weighted at the bottom with a little lead, and it's kind of light. It hits the water, sits straight up, or if you're fishing really deep, it'll just, if your baits land on the bottom, it'll just float on the top like that. But then sometimes it's a good indicator instead of something light to pull down. Instead of the big round buoys like we have. But I picked these up in Germany. Well, actually, these here were given to me by a dear friend of mine, old Bob Smith. Bless his soul. He's no longer with us. We used to fish together. Good fishing. But they're really good. He gave me a whole bag of them, so that's what I use as a little float. Nothing on the blue fox, so we're going to call it a day. So that's it. I'd like to thank everybody for joining me. As always, and if you have something special you want to see, please let me know. Drop me a comment below. Good or bad, I don't take it off. So from Hodgenville, Kentucky, thank you very much. Bye-bye. Everybody have a blessed day. See ya. Well, I was reeling in my line for the last time and catch some strange things fishing. Here's an old, it's two lures hooked to my bait and some grass, so we removed that. Here's a jig down here, here's a big old lure here, and that's mine. You catch some strange things. That's been in there a long, long time, so. Don't know how that happened. Whatever. I got a trash bag to put it in. You catch some strange things. Now, signing off for real. Bye.